Hey everybody, I wanted to take a minute today to talk about the healing of breast implant illness. And there is the expectation of how healing is going to go.
Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here, up in here. Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here, up in here.
And then there's the reality of how it actually goes. And although I am adding some humor here, I know that it's not funny when you're going through healing from breast implant illness. And when those flares hit, it's anything but a joke. However, I know that my girls can relate because you have an expectation coming out of surgery or even going into explant surgery that when you are done, you know, your implants are going to be gone and the healing is going to happen and it's going to be, you know, amazing and beautiful and wonderful. And that's not always the case. In fact, I think it's less often the case than we realize. And so when our healing gets ugly, we think that maybe something's wrong with us. And I am here to tell you that nothing is wrong with you, that healing is messy and it can get ugly and it can get hard, and that's okay. You're normal. We're all normal. What made me think to do this video is because I just went through a huge, terrible flare-up myself. I'm 17 months post-explant, and I started to feel awful again. The severe fatigue set in, and I had a headache that wouldn't go away for 5 weeks. And it wasn't just a headache. It was an inflammation and a pressure in my brain that I've never felt before. I had gone to the dentist right before, and I was in the middle of a flare when I went to the dentist, and I went for a routine cleaning, and I had a cancer screening, an oral cancer screening called Visalite. And it was one of those decisions that when I made it, I immediately regretted it. And she gave me this liquid to swish around in my mouth for like a minute. And when I was done and I asked her what ingredients were in what I had just put in my mouth, she didn't know. So I knew right then and there that it was probably a mistake because my body is so sensitive to everything. However, I had made the decision, so I had to live with it. I immediately started to get this headache that just wouldn't quit. So after suffering for 5 weeks and I was falling back into the same pattern of crying to my husband every night, not feeling well, he and my mom both begged me to go see a doctor. So I did. And my doctor ran my blood work, and I asked him to run my Epstein-Barr virus numbers, which he did, and they came back high. I had 3 numbers come back pretty high. He told me it was because of an old virus, which I had mono when I was a teenager. But I wasn't convinced that it was all those high numbers because of an old virus. So I went and saw my holistic practitioner, and she confirmed with me that the 2 numbers were because it was old, and the last number was because it was reactivated in my body. She said most likely I was going through a flare, and it was just exacerbated because the virus saw an opportunity. My immune system was weak, so it wanted to come out and play at that moment. She put me on antiviral medication, and after 7 days, I started feeling so much relief. I finally wasn't in pain, and the headache was going away, and the pressure in my brain was going away, which was amazing because I truly was suffering so badly. And the fatigue is starting to lift now. So I finally feel like I'm coming out of it again, but I'm seeing so many women, all of my friends, all my sisters who are struggling with flare-ups and their healing process. And I feel like you go through that all over again, feeling like you're alone, you're doing something wrong, something's wrong with your body, maybe it wasn't your implants after all. I don't want you to feel that way. You have to hold on to the fact that after you had your explant, there were things that all of a sudden disappeared, whether it took on immediately or whether it took a little while to come. It was your implants. And when you have breast implant illness, it's almost like an earthquake in your body. And then flare-ups are like the aftershock of this earthquake. And you have to look at it that way because these aftershocks are going to come. And when they do, you can't think that you've done something wrong or you're not doing enough for your healing. You have to remember that they're normal. And I'm somebody who has promoted just letting my body heal naturally and letting my body detox naturally. And the fact that I had severe biofilm in my chest from my implants, I'm realizing now that I'm going to need to do some more real detoxing of my body. So that's my next step in my healing process. But everybody's so individualized, and a lot of the doctors out there, they don't know exactly how to help us. So when these flares happen and when your healing gets nasty, reach out to your support group on your Facebook, social media, whatever you choose, because it's not always gonna be easy. And we're not alone, but we are the research, and the research is happening right now, which is amazing. But unfortunately, the women who are struggling right now don't have the answers that they need. So we kind of have to just lean on each other and be the support that we need right now. Flares are also a kind of a pain in the ass. And maybe you were doing really well and you felt like you were stopped in your tracks and that it's kind of unfair. We have to recognize and honor the fact that it is your body's way of continuing to heal. It's kind of like you have to take those few steps back in order to be able to move forward again. I also see some of our ladies struggling to explain some of this to their family members, and I know that that probably could be very frustrating. And so I'm speaking to the family members right now when I say, have some understanding. I know that us women tend to hold the household together, and that you guys, you know, the whole family relies on us and us feeling well, but this is a reality that we have to deal with. These aftershocks from our earthquake of breast implant illness. And so as the family members, I am asking you to be supportive of your woman going through what she's going through. She didn't ask for this. She didn't know that this was a possibility. And so just kind of try to be understanding when these flare-ups happen, because she doesn't want to feel sick. She doesn't want to be sick anymore, and she doesn't want to be paying for her mistake of implants any longer either. So please just, you know, be understanding as a family member, be supportive. And also, just like my husband and my mom, if they're being stubborn, if she's being stubborn, you know, really encourage her to go talk to somebody and help find someone maybe to, you know, that she can trust to help her guide her through this process. Just remember that you're not alone, and that healing isn't always going to be this amazing, wonderful thing that happens. You're not gonna be that llama that's prancing around all the time. Maybe some days you feel that way, and on those days, be grateful. Be grateful that you're feeling good and you're having a great day. But more often, you're gonna find that you're that hamster that's like, what the hell is going on? And I think that you're gonna find that you'll eventually have more llama days than hamster days. But we don't know how long that's gonna take for us to get there. It could take years. And so just really, you're gonna have to just hang on to your faith and remember that the best thing that you could have done for your body was get those implants out, because it truly is the only way that your body and your immune system are going to be able to heal. You know, they had you so bogged down for how long? I only had my implants for 3 years. Now I'm at almost a year and a half post-explant, and I'm still struggling. So someone who's had their implants for 15, 20, 30 years, it's gonna take a while, but you are gonna be okay. And this was the only way for you to be able to heal, and it was the best thing that you could do for your body. So try not to get discouraged. Try to listen to what your body's telling you. Don't be stubborn like me and take 5 weeks to go see the doctor and go talk to somebody. I struggled for 5 weeks. That was so stupid. I knew something was wrong. I was freaking scared and in complete denial. So don't be me. reach out and talk to people. Find yourself a holistic doctor. Find yourself a naturopath. You know, whatever avenue you want to go, but somebody that you can trust and somebody that will be able to guide you through this process, because it's not going to be easy, but it's absolutely going to be worth it. So listen, I just want you guys to know that you're not alone and that I am always here if you need me. And there's so many other women out there that are so knowledgeable in all of the detox process and the healing process. So reach out. You're not alone. You don't have to be scared. You don't have to be alone. And don't wait. When you feel those symptoms coming back on, definitely reach out. And just take good care of yourselves. Okay? Bye.